Hello, I'm Mr. R. Richard, and I was describing this is video Gnostic Trinity and Gospel video number 13. I was describing the Satgurus that came in India after Nanak, is the light of Nanak they carried. And the first one was Satguru Angad Dev Ji, and he killed the ego of the people. He asked them to subdue their ego, ego of the tribe, or ego of a good physical body, or any type ego to be subdued. And he made people to submit to the will of God in full. Even if there is no rain, they should not be frightened. They should have peace of mind and believe in God. And he will sustain the life. Then we had a next one. When the ego is overpowered, then you become sensible, twice born, and those people are doubting and they want to go for money rather than God. So the preaching of Satguru Amar Dev Ji was directed towards mind, not to become greedy, to be contented and to go for God. So here he requested people to get themselves sealed to serve God. And those who got sealed to serve God, his name was Ram Das, Satguru Ram Das. As the name stand, Ram mean God, Das mean a servant. So he was the servant of God, mean that instead of doing a administrative work, as wise men do, you do the opposite. You serve people in the name of God. And then the last one is the one celestial word, which is called Satguru Arjan Dev Ji. Now, Satguru Arjan Dev Ji was a highly spiritual person and who had the fruit of the service. He got it, the very, very God in him. Or he became the very greatest, you know, Christ. And he became as equal to Satguru Nanak Ji's status. And same as Christ Jesus' status. So he was totally mammon free. And he even was so mammon free that he sold his ornament to carry on the kitchen of the Sikhs. So he had a very great opposition from his elder brother Prithi Chand, who was such a shameless person that nobody will be equal to him. And those people, the Prithi Chand's generation, they occupied the Harmandir Sahib, and they were very cruel, and even they throw out the last Christ on earth, Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji, who was the sixth. The details of these I have presented in my Punjabi videos and in English, so I'm not going to give you much information about that in this video. Then we have the spiritual stages, which we called lama. Lama means pulling. Lama is the rope that we use to pull water from a well. So this is in spiritual term, the lama means how to pull a Sikh from one spiritual state to the stage to the other. So Satguru Angad Dev Ji had an intake of very raw material, a natural man. So he gave them the education or preaching to subdue their ego and become spiritual, from natural to spiritual people. Remember that ego and spirit, they are enemy of each other, so they can't dwell in the same house. And So the first now is directed towards how to live in the secular world so that morally sound, so that you can become a spiritual person of good standing. So Amar Dev Ji was again, as I stress, how to conduct your economical life, not to be greedy and just to be contented. So the third law is devoted towards that when you want, if you want to progress further, you must serve the people, because in everyone is the light of God. So there is no enemy or stranger to a Sikh. He sees the light of God in everybody, even in enemy. So that's why they say, love your enemy. And then we had Sadhguru Arjan Dev Ji, who was the apostle of humility, humbleness. So he was the one who was put on hot plate and hot sand poured over his head, and he was there for 4 days. And he was singing the hymns of God, that your will is very sweet. That means he did not complain against anybody. So he gave the total submission to the will of God. And here is worth mentioning that when Christ Jesus was on the cross, he never cried, "Oh Father, why have you forgiven me, forgotten me," and all that. He died with submission to the will of God, and he did not complain against the prosecution or prosecutors. So then next one, we have the royal kings. In India, we have 6 Christ and 4 royal kings. So the first one in the once-born people, the royal king devoted to that one was Har Rai Ji. Har Rai Ji is of Shudar one. Shudar means service. So he opened hospitals to serve people. Then next one, twice born, is Vash. And Vash means sensible. And here is the Sache Pasha Har Krishan Ji, a royal king Har Krishan Ji. He rendered the exposition of the saying of Satgurus to the extreme, that he left no stone unturned in the exposition. So the next one is the one who is a political affair to look after, or administration, was Gobind Singh Ji, and he created Khalsa, who are the political wing, but philanthropist. They don't go for secular kingdom, but they see that secular kings run the kingdom in justice. There is no cruelty or no injustice. So they fought for justice. And the last one is Har Gobind Ji. He was the one who did the Brahman Varn. So that means the education. So in his name, we have Akal Takht. Akal Takht is the seat of the apostles, or seat of the Nirmala Sant. But today, we have sitting over there, we can call, who have no knowledge of their own secular father, and never mind of God, and they are the most stupid people sitting on top of the Akal Takht. You have no example to that one. So they are also throwing out edicts and everything, when everybody has to do the will of our father, not the will of these addicts or the antichrist sitting there. So there will be a lot of trouble in India, and hope that this will give some introduction. Thank you.